My name's Mark Scott. I'm a postdoctoral researcher working at the intersection of millifluidics and biology. The thing I like most about my work is that no 2 days are ever the same. You come into work and you never know what experiments are going to work, which experiments are going to fail, and you really just can't predict which day the breakthrough is going to happen. If you imagine the work of a biologist, they tend to be pipetting media and cells into flat petri dishes, but that world is fast changing. In microfluidics and millifluidics, the work is very planar, so it's sort of tagged on to the semiconductor industry where you're working on flat wafers and you're stuck in two dimensions. And this really limits the way you can sort of switch materials and fluids and where you can flow reagents A and B. And 3D printing has really changed that in allowing you to enter the third dimension. And as a result, you can shuttle materials through and past each other in different and new and exciting ways. If you have a 3D printer, then you can really teach concepts very quickly. And both engineering and biology and physics concepts can all be taught using 3D models, and the students can conceivably, in the course of an afternoon, design, print, and test a device, which is really not feasible without a 3D printer.